Let's look at Psalm chapter 2. The main idea of Psalm chapter 2 is that the wise take refuge in God. So again, just like Psalm 1, the purpose of this psalm is to identify who God's people are. In Psalm 1, we learn that God's people are blessed because they are blessed. They delight in the law of the Lord. They're not the wicked, but rather they're delighting in God. So the blessed delight in God. Here we learn that the blessed are wise. Namely, they submit to the Lord's rule. So let's go ahead and take a look at this passage together. It begins by asking a question: why are the nations raging and plotting in vain? The nations, the kings of the nations, are setting themselves against the Lord and against the King of Israel. They're saying, let's burst their bonds apart. So what we see in this passage is that the nations rebel against the rule of God. And the Lord responds by laughing. He holds them in derision. Moreover, he speaks to them in his wrath and terrifies them in his fury. He says, a statement of sovereignty, I have set my king in Zion. So these nations are raging against the Lord and against the King of Israel, but the Lord is in sovereign control. He does as he wills. He sets his king in Jerusalem, in Zion. Now the king responds by telling us the decree. The Lord said to me, you are my son. Today I have begotten you. Ask of me and I will make the nations your heritage. So on the one hand, the nations are raging against God, but at God's command, they become the heritage of his son. The ends of the earth will become his possession. The king of Israel that God is going to set in Jerusalem is going to rule with a rod of iron and dash the nations together like a potter's vessel. So what we see here is that the nations are inclined to waging war against the Lord, but the Lord is in sovereign control. His king will reign despite these plots and despite this rage. So what should happen? The psalm says, therefore, the nations should be wise, the nations should be warned. What should they be warned of? That God is in sovereign control over all things. So what should the nations do? They should serve the Lord with fear and rejoice with trembling. They should kiss the Son. These three ideas are indicating that the nations should submit to the rulership of the Lord and the King of Israel. And why? Because the Lord's anger can come quickly. There is a warning here. God will judge those who rule against him. Therefore, be warned, be wise, take refuge in the Lord. Take refuge in the Lord's anointed. So in Psalm 2, we learn about who is the blessed one. The blessed one is the wise one who takes refuge in the Lord and in the Lord's anointed. They don't rage in war against the Lord's anointed. Rather, they take refuge in him. At this point, I want to draw our attention to the fact that Psalm 2 ends with the statement, blessed are those who take refuge. And Psalm 1 begins with the statement, blessed is the man. When read together, these psalms are indicating to us who is the blessed man. The blessed man delights in the law of God. The blessed man who delights in the law of God takes refuge in God. So delighting in God's word is a delight because it is a source of protection. Our God is our protection. He is our source of safety. And the blessed person takes refuge in him. So here are some questions we could ask in our small groups. First, we can ask them to identify two characteristics of the blessed person and two characteristics of the wicked person using Psalm 1 and 2. We can also have them compare how God responds on the one hand to the wicked in Psalm 2 and how he responds to the righteous, his king, in Psalm 2. Notice that the Lord speaks in his wrath against the nations, but he speaks glorious things about his son. So we can have them compare God's response to the wicked with his response to the son. Also, another good question is to ask, are we acting like the Blessed One in our lives? Namely, are we, on the one hand, delighting in God's law? And on the other hand, are we taking refuge in God? And how do we know? So asking them to evaluate their lives to see whether or not they're delighting in God and taking refuge in God is very, very important. And perhaps a final question we can ask is, notice how the kings, the nations, when they come together, they plot in vain. They make plans that are vain because they don't want to submit to Christ. I think a good question we can ask is something along the lines of, how do we make sure that our small groups, when we come together, we don't come together vainly, but we come together for the glory of God? How do we make sure our gatherings are not in vain? And I think the answer is we need to make sure our gatherings are fueling our delight in God and driving us to take refuge in the Lord and his anointed. So having them think through those questions might be helpful. All right, I hope this helps you lead the small group on Psalm chapter 1.